carols and candles. This is one of the most anticipated events of our church year. Events is really a word that's not adequate enough for what this night is. It's a sacred moment, isn't it? As we, through the carols and candles program, participate, share the joy of this Advent and Christmas season. Thank you for being part of this very, very special night for St. James United Methodist Church and for our community. Now, cell phones. Let's talk about cell phones a moment. You do not want to be the one. You don't want to be the one who forgets to turn that off. And it goes off with some 1960s Elvis music. And for three cues, everyone's looking at you. Don't be that person. Turn this off. Let's enjoy the music of carols and candles. And we'll share a prayer together. Our God, we give you thanks tonight, this special night. This Christmas, this Advent season that prepares our hearts for Christmas, is one filled with joy. Part of our joy in this congregation is our chancel choir and the festival singers, the orchestra, carols and candles. The opportunity we have tonight to share in this joy, for this we give you thanks. We pray your blessing. In Christ's name.
Thank you.
In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham, and to his descendants forever."
Thank you. night. This song is probably one of the most chilling Christmas songs ever written. It is amazing, miraculous, awe-inspiring. I'm sure for all of us, there are times when we start to lose sight of what Christmas is really all about. And this is a song that brings us back. And it's times like that when I remember the line, "Fall on your knees." That is one amazing line. That is what we are called to do in this time. Fall on our knees with gratitude, love, and joy. Even when we're wrapping presents and trying to find the perfect nutcracker for an incredibly picky six-year-old, we are to remember that these gifts are given to remind us of the ultimate gift. These sacrifices we make when we forego sleep to wrap presents or to bake desserts, when we save and scrimp and allocate money to scrumptious rib roasts for the whole family by eating beans and rice in the weeks leading up to the big day. These are sacrifices that we make in honor and remembrance of the sacrifice that secured for us the possibility of forgiveness and redemption. Everything we do in the weeks of Advent, the waiting, the patience, the silent reflection, the preparation, the planning, the errands, and the baking, all these things are such pale reflections of what was done for us. After all, why do we drive ourselves to distraction in the days before Christmas? We plan elaborate menus complete with our favorite family recipes and try to find the perfect gift for everyone in our family so that we can see their faces. Because bringing joy and happiness to others makes us happy. The sacrifices we make in the weeks and days leading up to Christmas are so small compared to the sacrifice God made, sending his son into a terribly wounded world, allowing him to be hunted, tormented, scorned, rejected, accused, tortured, and finally hung on a cross to die, all so that he could see our faces, so that he could bring us true joy for all of eternity. Friends, it was indeed a holy night.
Thank you.
The wise men came from far away, brought gifts to the newborn, all for the glory of God. Tonight we have the opportunity to send our gifts far away. For every 60 seconds, malaria claims a life in Africa. Imagine how malaria is a ministry of the people of the United Methodist Church, putting our faith into action to end preventable death by malaria in Africa. United Methodist Foundation of Arkansas is matching every gift, so our offering tonight will be doubled. To give you an understanding of the scale of what we are able to do, it only takes $10 to save a life. Now, I looked at last year's offering. If we gave just the same amount this year, after the matching gift, we could save about 600 lives on that tonight. And there are about 600 people in the room right now. So this is how many lives we can save. So far, in just a few years, United Methodist Church has cut the mortality rate in half. Tonight, let us gather at the manger and offer our gifts to the Christ child, knowing that every one of our gifts can save lives. I invite the ushers to come forward to receive God's tithe and our offering as we pray. Gracious God, we thank you for the season of carols and gifts, and for your most precious gift of Jesus. We offer you our lives and these gifts, that others' lives may be saved in your holy name. Lord, please accept this offering and transform it into the work you're reigning on this earth, as we make ready for the newborn Christ. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
What a joy it has been to share this night of music with you. Following the concert, we invite you to join us for a lovely reception prepared by our kind and Methodist women. The reception is in our great hall, which is out these doors to your right. And we thank you for being part of telling the story, our story. This evening we have sung many words, words that have been crafted by poets and writers over many years. Words that have been written to express our faith and the story of this amazing gift, Emmanuel, God with us. Of all the words shared this evening, I want to direct your hearts and minds to words we will sing in this next song and how we will close out our concert this evening. You've all heard the scripture, and we'll hear it again in a few moments, of how the angels sang glory to God in the highest. And the poet Eileen Berry reminds us in this next song that the song the angel sings is to you. As she writes in three different statements, she said, O fallen world, to you is the song. O fearful world, to you is the song. O friendless world, to you is the song. To you is the song proclaiming the good news of the birth of the Messiah. After hearing the Luke passage read in a little bit, we will close our concert with a song the angel sang, Glory to God in the highest. May you carry these words in your heart, for to you is the song. And may that song bring you hope and peace this Christmas.
Thank you.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. She gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing which has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them.